Jason Allen here from PlayIt Software, and today we're going to look at the groundbreaking new feature for going live in PlayIt Live. It's Remote Studio. So here we are in PlayIt Live 2.14, and the first thing you'll notice is a new section here that says Jason Allen, Remote Studio. This indicates that a remote presenter is connected via Remote Studio, a web-based interface that enables presenters to access PlayIt Live from anywhere in the world using just a web browser. To begin using Remote Studio, go to File and enable Remote Connections, and click Start Server. Under Help Me Set Up External Access, take a copy of the external web address at the bottom and open this in a web browser. Right now we support Chrome-based browsers such as Google Chrome and Microsoft Edge. Once you're in the web browser, click on the Remote Studio app icon and log in with your PlayIt Live username and password. If you haven't set up any users yet in PlayIt Live, you can easily add a new user by going to Manage and then Users. Once you are logged in, you will be prompted to allow access to your microphone. Click on Allow, and then the web browser will establish a real-time connection with PlayIt Live. Remote Studio's browser interface mirrors the main interface that you'll see on PlayIt Live. You can perform all the normal tasks like dragging and dropping tracks, reordering the playout log, and even editing segues. Remote presenters can also go live with PlayIt Live by clicking the Start Live Audio button. Once live, the audio from the studio can be heard, and there's an option to add your microphone to the mix. There are two key buttons here, the Unmute button, which turns your microphone on, and the Duck button, which reduces the studio audio levels. The Duck button only becomes active when your microphone is unmuted. With my microphone muted, the levels on the meter marked as U appear in grey. Unmuting my microphone sends my microphone to air and turns these levels green. If I raise my voice, you'll see that my levels turn yellow, and if I speak even louder, they turn red. Ideally, your microphone levels should peak at the top of the green and maybe dip slightly into yellow. If your microphone is too quiet or too loud, you can adjust the volume using the microphone gain slider. If you want to talk over the music at the end of the song, you can use the Duck button. This lowers the studio audio, allowing you to speak over it at a sensible level. The level to which the audio lowers can be controlled by sliding the duck marker at the bottom of the slider. You can also adjust the speed of the ducking in the live audio settings, which you can find under the cog icon. In this section, you'll find the duck duration, as well as the audio devices for studio audio playback and your microphone. I'll now show a quick demo of speaking over the end of a song and the start of the next one. Splendid Colour and Leave a Light On. It's Jason here on PlayIt 80s.
From WAM to Culture Club, this is PlayIt 80s.
And next up, we got a bit of this. It's of course Phil Oakey and Georgie Moroder with Together in Electric Dreams. A classic from the 1980s. PlayIt Live Remote Studio also allows for multiple presenters to connect simultaneously for co-hosting or facilitating a show handover. The second presenter logs in and connects to Remote Studio in the same manner as the first. Once connected, a second host will appear on the live audio panel, with their audio levels initially in grey, and turning green when their microphone is live. Presenters can communicate with each other off-air using the Talkback feature. When multiple presenters are connected, click the walkie-talkie icon when your microphone is muted to send your microphone to other presenters without the audio going to air. When Talkback is enabled, the studio monitoring levels are dipped and the microphone audio levels are shown in purple. From a station management perspective, users can be configured to go live only at specific times during the week. However, they can log in at any time to plan their show for those designated times. Any hours outside their access will be shown as read-only on the playout log. When going live, presenters can connect up to 5 minutes before their designated time and will be disconnected automatically 5 minutes after. It's also worth mentioning that presenters must start live audio in order to perform actions such as play, pause, and stop. This is a necessary safety feature designed to prevent accidental operation of PlayIt Live. So Remote Studio is a new feature that will change the way remote presenters do live radio. It makes it easier for them to use it from anywhere in the world with just a web browser. Remote Studio is part of the Remote Management module for PlayIt Live, and you can find more information at playitsoftware.com/pricing. I look forward to trying out Remote Studio, and if you have any tips and tricks for remote broadcasting, please feel free to share them in the comments section below. And to keep up to date with the latest goings on at PlayIt Software, you can subscribe to us on YouTube and like us on Facebook. I've been Jason Allen from PlayIt Software.